Oh, hello, Yoda. Hey, hello, Christopher. Hello, Miner. Hello, Jay. You wouldn't believe this rig I have set up here. I have this microphone taped to my tripod with an old popcorn bucket filled with electronics holding it down. I'm sitting on the floor in an empty room. I'm trying to set up for the dad New Year's Eve stream. And I figured I'd show you guys my new hat. Riley, I'll tell you how it happened. I was gifted by an angel. So here, let me explain this. First of all, I'm doing this stream for a reason because... All right, let me fix that. Can you guys hear? Yeah, you can hear me. So I moved, Christopher. I moved out of Los Angeles. I'm here for a year. I've had a very, very hard time since I got here. Like... moving wise, what's been happening to me wise, I'm only getting this apartment for a week. I have to move apartments. It's been bonkers. Very, very, I haven't had this hard of a time emotionally and physically in a long time. So I was like, I gotta do the stream. I gotta say this, get this over with, because this is a whole other thing that I should probably tell the world. And I had to explain why and how the heck this happened. Hello, everyone. Read the title of the stream. This will be pretty amusing, I think. So anyways, I'm trying to tell everyone this story, and then I will have nothing to think about ever again. So check this out. My hair came back. I still got a bald spot and a major receding hairline. But it's shaved, obviously. So, my friend, they took my hair from the back and put it in the front because I was fascinated by this idea. If I was fascinated, like, I'm very happy as myself. I'm very happy bald. I love being bald. It's how I make a living. I could not be more confident of a person. So I want to tell you all, I insist, I'm not a self-conscious person at all. I'm overly confident. Even when I look at Keith Trailerwell's long hair, bald hair, I love myself and how I look. But I'm fascinated by this. So my friend, I have two friends who got hair transplants because they didn't like that they were balding. And we would always talk about, we have text chains about it, like, oh, what's it look like now? It was intriguing to me how this is possible. Like, you're basically cheating. One of my favorite things in video games is me and my brother say, video game says no. And we love when video game says no because we say yes. Like, things happen in a video game where, like, you can't go to this certain area. But if you can force the game, you can glitch through it, then you really beat the game. So with that mentality, I also feel that and think that with nature and, like, how can you defeat nature and go against what the rules of the universe are. So my friend got hair transplants, and they look like they have full hair. They just basically – I don't have a scar or anything like that. It's like, no scars. They basically just took a bunch of hairs from the back of my head, put it there. 4 hours later, I had hair. It's right there. It's growing. It's very short right now. And apparently this is all going to, like, fall out. And then in, like, a month, it's all going to be back. So, I mean, if people think it's lame, I really just don't care. I just have to say it because I'm going to have a hair. I'm going to look like this, but it'll be longer. I'm basically going to look like I did when I was 28. This is what I used to look like. I had a bald spot, a receding hairline. So I did it. Because I was fascinated by it. And my friends, after seeing them have it, it was like so interesting. I'm like, I have to try this. And I did it out of boredom and out of fascination. It wasn't painful at all. I have two friends that did it that said their heads hurt for a month. And I kept telling them, like, I don't have any pain. I don't have any pain. Like, there's no pain, nothing. Like, and this happened like a month ago. So this is what I will mostly look like, and it will get longer. So I mostly look the same. I have like a hairline like I did when I was Keith and stuff. So Keith's hair was like this. Anyways, this is my new hair. It came back. I wanted to tell everyone because I feel like it's going to be shocking if all of a sudden I start shooting videos and it's like, wait, his hair is back. How'd that happen? A lot of times people think, and I also add hair to my head. I glue hair, so maybe people wouldn't even notice. And I showed my mom and dad, and they didn't even notice. I sent them pictures, and then I FaceTimed them, and they're like, oh no, why did you shave your head? Because my parents don't like when I have short hair like this. My parents had no idea that I had hair in the front. I have bangs right here. Granted, it looks pretty much the same. So this is what I said to the doctor. I said, out of curiosity, I was like, do you think I could get hair? And he goes, don't even bother. That's the first thing he said to me. I had like a FaceTime consultation and he said, don't even bother. It wasn't too expensive. What I did was that BMW I had, I sold my BMW and I got it with that. And I had money left over. I had a few thousand left over. So it was like, I didn't need the car. I wasn't filming neutral. That was like the money that it went towards. But I wasn't telling anyone that. Well, I didn't do it. I didn't sell the car for that. But I was like, well, I can sell this car and then I'll have cash and I'll do it. So it helped me feel better about it. I don't feel more confident at all. Like literally nothing has changed. Like I'm telling you, I have too much confidence already. I feel great. I always feel cool. I'm very happy with myself. I don't think I'm an egomaniac, but I've always felt good. And I actually like looking funky and ugly and messing my hair up and growing it long and doing the comb over. I like walking around town where I look psycho for my videos and making people look over at me and like I'm living in the character for the times I'm filming my videos. So like I've never been self-conscious. But I also think if I do this stream and I talk about this, it might be interesting for some people who aren't happy with their balding hair and they're maybe intrigued and like as to how it works and what's going on, because it's fascinating, and that's why I did it. So I have two friends who've done it, actually a few friends, some friends I'm closer with more. It's like you learn, like I start finding out all these people who've done it. I'm like, oh really? So I have some friends that have done it, and they have like their hair looks perfect. Like it looks like you would never know. And like those friends, no, most people didn't know they were losing the hair, but they did. They had like bald spots or it was thinning or they had a hairline. I was completely obvious. I was fully bald all the way gone. Thank you for all these. I see your comments. Thank you, everyone. I'll talk about moving after in a minute, Ryan. But I see you guys saying nice things. I appreciate it very much. Thank you very much. I don't mean to say this because I'm like, oh, please don't hate me. Don't make fun of me. I just have to tell you guys because eventually you're going to be like, wait a second. What happened to his bald head? But I mean, this is going to be thinner. When this grows out, it's not going to be as thick as the sides. So what I said to the guy was, I was like, what do you think? And he goes, don't even bother. And I was like, well, let me tell you what I want. I said, first of all, I don't care about having a full head of hair. I don't want hair. I'm very happy how I am, but I'm just kind of interested to see if it can work. And I'm the kind of person that I do very random things just to do them, just to try them. I buy motorcycles all the time. I buy old cars. I sell them. I got a super expensive car one time and I couldn't afford it. I got a Range Rover and then I sold it like 10 months later. I was like, well, that was cool. I had that car. I move randomly. Here I am. I left Los Angeles. Probably going back next year, by the way. One time I went to France on a 24 hours notice and then I flew the girl I was dating there. I went to Bora Bora a couple weeks. I started dating a girl, Siobhan, the girl, you guys know her. I talk about her. I was like, you want to go to Bora Bora? She's like, okay. 2 weeks later, we went to Bora Bora. Like, I really like to do sporadic things. That's how I live. I've always been kind of like bonkers in that way. So I was like thinking, I'm going to do it. I just really want to see if this can work and if the science in the hair can regrow. So I said to him, after he said, don't even bother, I said, let me tell you what I want. I said, I want the Bruce Willis from 1995 or whatever, from Die Hard. And then he's like, okay. And I said, give me Bill Murray's hair. Bruce Willis or Bill Murray or Jason Statham, even though Jason Statham is mostly bald. I said, I wanted that. I go, could you do that? Like, basically just give me. And I showed him pictures of myself when I was 28, and this is what I looked like. He basically saw, you could see, because I still have fuzz. Some of this hair is actually mine. I just cleaned it up. There is some of my hair there. And I often clean it up for when I do the dad thing. So he just followed my hairline based on my pictures and put it back to what, put my hair from the back to where it was in the front. And it worked. So here it is. Ta-da! There you go, everybody. I told the world. I felt weird about not telling anyone because I felt like that was kind of strange to like hide it. And I'm very vocal and I talk about everything. So I just thought it would be kind of interesting to tell everyone that I have hair. Oh my gosh, thank you, doctor. Nice hair, bro. Thank you very much. As you settle into your new place. Thank you. Yeah. Hey, Ryu, Jimmy, check it out. So this isn't what it's gonna look like. I mean, let's see if I can get you show you like you see this, see it's like stubbly. And I don't ever have my hair this short. They basically had to cut it really short to do this. And then there was I just he, and then there was like some, he left long hair right here and it looks really weird. So I just cut it all short. Apparently this, my friends who've had them are like, it's gonna fall out. This will fall out. The doctor said it will fall out. And then by March, it will start growing again like normal hair. So I apparently will look like my bald normal self in a month or so. But it's not falling out. Nothing has fallen out. And so the guy told me too, this is kind of interesting. He goes, I think you could come back next year and do another one if you want. But I'm thinking that's probably too much. I don't want to just have thick, full hair. I'm not looking to do that. I was just wanted to see if this would work and it would take. I don't mind it being thin. But he did say, he goes, if you wanted to do another one, I could take some more and fill it in and be thicker. And he goes, and then I could even do a third one with your neck hair. This guy's like the best guy in Los Angeles. So possibly the best in the country because LA has like the best people who do this like cosmetic garbage. So, anyways, oh, thank you, CC Games. Thank you. I actually have, so it's funny because like I still wash my hair, obviously, on the sides, but like I bought baby shampoo
Nice
and I've been
action.
watching it very carefully. Oh, you guys are giving money. Thank you, guys. Thanks, CC. Yeah, Varza. It's pretty bonkers. Basically, the guy replicated what I looked like when I was 28 years old. And it's still my hair. There's no big scar on the back. That's I forget what they call that method, the strip method or whatever. They take a strip of your hair and then they put it up front and you have a scar. I didn't do that. It was super non-invasive. It took 4 hours. I was home back to doing whatever. It was really crazy how fast and easy it was. So it didn't even feel like anything really happened. So yeah, it was pretty bonkers. That's what, and I sold my car and I still had money left over. And there you go. And I'm eating on the floor in my apartment that I'm only going to be until Monday because I have to move again to another place because this place was not what I was expecting it to be. So I'm booming out and I'm eating really bad ramen from 7-Eleven. Yes, Ryu, that keeps stuff people that you always see advertised is like full, it's totally garbage. None of that stuff ever works. So, anyways, I just wanted to tell you, Rory, that here it is. I have hair, and it depends. It's some people, so A, it depends on how much hair you need that what it costs. And like, I didn't get much because I told I wanted the hairline, so I wanted to look like me still. I didn't want a full head of hair. My back of my head is still bald. I have the big bald spot in the back. So this cost 10,000, which it's a lot of money, but I sold my car for 15,000 and I used the other money to move. And I was like, all right, it's a present for myself. And something I was talking to my brother Seth about it. And he's like, you're going to look like Barry. You don't want to look like Barry. Cause my brother worked at the TV Guide channel when we first moved to LA. And there was a guy, Barry, who they used to work in the basement apparently. And he had plugs and it looked super gross. So, he's like, you're going to look like Barry. Don't do it. And then we're talking about my friend who has it, and it looks perfect. Yeah. So anyway, my hair will grow normally. But oh, the thing I didn't finish saying was he said the doctor said, he goes, your neck is a treasure trove of hair. He goes, you could use beard hair after you do one more from here, and then you could use beard hair and you could fill it in. But I'm thinking, I don't want to have a full head of hair. I actually got pretty upset afterwards because it didn't look like the me that I've seen for the past like 12 years or however long I've been fully bald. That's so it felt a little weird to do it. I felt like I was betraying myself and betraying my brother and my dad. Yeah, Yoda, I told Yoda about it as a fellow bald man. I told him about it. Thank you guys for donating. That's really nice of you guys. Thanks, Vidyacraft. I've seen your name before. Thanks for being here. So yeah, I did it. It's interesting, and it's like I just keep staring at it. It's like this the point for me to do this was to just like see if it could happen and like be fascinated by it. I'm sending pictures to my friend who also got it because it's really interesting to me that it can just take a hair and put you could put it right here and it would just grow. And it's immune to bald. And it's like, well, if I can do the 90s Bruce Willis like I used to look like, if I can get the Bill Murray, why not? it won't look like, if I was like trying to get a full head of hair, it would look super cheesy and lame and stupid. And I wanted the bald spot in the back. I wanted the hairline. Oh, thank you, doctor. Thank you. That's very nice of you. But yeah, I understand how it can be looked at as a kind of like a shallow thing or a I don't know. It can look be looked down upon negatively. So if anyone feels that way, that's all right. I do what I want when I want why I want, and I did this. But I thought that was pretty interesting. They said my neck. He could use my beard hair because it's so thick. And actually, this is actually very soft. It's like not. It's thick, but it's very soft beard hair. And I was like, well, that'd be kind of cool. But I don't know if it looked too like I have too much hair at that point where it's gonna be like, all right, man, calm down. Or I should just be like more subtle, like, oh, a little bit grew back. Because I could where it used to be when I was 28, which is where it is now, it could be thicker. And it would be, because this will be a little thinner than the side. Where can you guys see? Than the side of the head. So I was like, well, I could even it out. But then I was thinking I can still shave the top of my head like I have been. Because I do, for the dad character, I do clean up the top because I do have like some hair up there. But now I won't have to clean it up, I guess. It'll like just grow in with this. But if I ever want to do like the dad character. But the thing is, I also have prepared this because I was thinking about this for a while. I have a whole thing in the story that will work for dad with him having the Bruce Willis hair. And also think about Die Hard and then think about Dad Ass. So that's something I've thought about where this technically is now like right here. I have all these wigs from all my characters in this box next to me. The hair I had in the Milford short film, I have it right here. I'm thinking, well, this is the same thing. This, I just paid for a video. This is just a prop sitting on my head. Oh, thanks, Proton. I don't know. So anyways, I figured this could be an interesting conversation. Or maybe you guys don't really care and you're like, okay, fine, you barely look any different. My own parents, I'm telling you, my parents didn't even notice. I was like, Mom, my mom looks at me every day. I FaceTime with my parents all the time and they didn't know. She's like, oh, I just thought you cut it short. And I have other friends have told me that they just think I shaved it for the characters. Many people have told me that. A lot of people used to think that I made Keith's hair bald for characters because I am pretty committed to characters. So I'm not surprised people think that because I do go pretty far for things. Well, thank you, Varza, for saying that. Oh, did Elon have like bald hair before? Thank you for donating that. And his Yoda is saying that. Proton, thanks a lot. Thanks again, Doctor. But I don't know. I don't know anything. I don't know if he got a hair transplant. I just know like Matthew McConaughey and stuff. And the guy I went to, like he said celebrities go to him all the time, but he obviously can't tell. So he won't be able to tell that I went there too. He won't be able to tell anyone else because I consider myself a celebrity too. Thanks for subscribing, Krusty. So, oh, did he really? Prody? You know, he also might do like stem cells and stuff because he's super rich. And like, I heard like stem cells are $100,000 per session. He's probably done many. I need to see a before and after picture of Elon. Can someone send me a before and like a link to a before and after? I don't know if that's possible. On Elon, you notice immediately, or you notice on me? Yeah, I mean, like, you guys watch my videos, and you guys see me every day, so I'm not surprised you would notice, because I'm bald. I was actually, like, thinking some people who didn't even know me might notice, when they just be like, oh, that just doesn't seem right. But I will say, when it's longer and it's growing, I know it looks a little different now, because it's short, and it's, like, not even, and, like, it's just kind of a mess. Right now it's not shaved even either, like they didn't do a great job, and then I tried to clean it up with my beard trimmers. So once it like grows, when this falls out, apparently this is gonna fall out, we'll see if that actually happens. It's supposed to be part of the process, like shock loss they call it, and then it will start growing again in like March this summer, they say. By 6 months it'll look like normal. But one cool thing, this is one cool thing the doctor said to me, he said my hair was very thick in the back, like I had very dense hair in the back. And when they take out each little hair, like seed, if you want, each little thing that they pull out from the back, they'd put them down on this like, you know, tray or whatever. And then they'd plug them in the front. He said, John, I'm not anymore, John. Thank you. Oh, Zizek. Is it Zizek's? Did you consider a scalp? I've never even heard of that. Is that like the, oh, is that the tattoo? Ew, ew, I would never do that. Honestly, I didn't even ever want to do this. It just started entering my mind earlier this year after my friend did it, and I was so fascinated by it, and his looks, but he wasn't, none of them were bald like me. They weren't like fully bald guys. They had like receded hairlines, or it was thin, or they had a bald spot, and no one really ever noticed. I'm like 100% bald. Not getting any balder. So I was like, this is a big jump. It's like if Larry David had hair, everyone would be like, what the heck? It's like when George walked in with hair on Seinfeld. That's basically me now. So one thing the guy said when he was taking the hairs out, he says, you're very fortunate because most of the graft, it's like each seed that they pull out each time they pluck one. Oh, thank you, Ren. Thank you very much. He said when he was pulling them out, I have 2 to 3 hairs per graph. So he says, so if they, and he took 2,013, he plucked 2,013 times from all over my head, and I got about 6,000 hairs right here. So I got pretty fortunate that each graph, each seed had multiple hairs coming out of it, which makes it look good. For being so bald, I get better coverage. So there, I could next year if I wanted to do another one where they pull more, he fills it in. And then I could even do the third one he was saying where he would take some beard hair, and I have so much beard hair and this grows way faster than my head hair. And he would then fill in random spots. Because if you had like all beard hair, that would look weird. You'd have like this crazy like thorn hair. So I was like, I mean, that fascinates me, having the beard hair here. Really, you're just moving it like 9 inches to somewhere else in your body, so it's not that strange. But like, I saw pictures and videos of other people from in Turkey, they do hair transplants for like $3,000, and you get like a full head of hair. But they're not, I don't know how great they are, but like, it's really cheap, and they'll take it from your chest, your armpits, your arms. They'll take it from anywhere. Me and my friend watched this video of this guy who had hair taken from all over, and they were just scrounging it up and giving him hair, and then he just like cuts it all the same length and brushes it, and it's like, it worked, but like, his whole body is bare naked. Thank you, Proton. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you, thank you, thank you. No, El Toro, 6,000 hairs for $10,000. That's what I got. But 2,000 grafts, but each one has multiple hairs in it. That's what happened. Yeah, but that's so like what you said, Missy Calvi, is like putting hair in a doll's head. That's what my brother Seth was afraid of. He kept saying, you're going to look like Barry. And Barry was a guy he worked with at TV Guide who had plugs probably from like the 90s, and he looked crazy. Just like wires coming out of his head. So my brother was afraid of that, and then that freaked me out. And I was like thinking, they don't do that anymore. So no, seeing my friend's hair, who I hadn't seen my friend in years because I didn't live anywhere near him. But he sent pictures and videos all day. His hair looked amazing. So anyway, I was like, I'm going to do it. And now this is like my experiment for myself, just to like stare at it. And I don't think it changes me too much. Where I honestly just didn't want the audience, like you guys and people watching my videos, to like think ill of me in any way and think like, oh, that's lame of him to do, or I abandoned any of my bald fans or something. Or I don't know, not like it because I don't look like my characters anymore. But when I first started filming videos, even Keith had the hair in the middle up front here. So I feel like, well, it's still just me. And it's just a fun experiment for me to do before I blow up and don't exist on this planet anymore. I always think, may as well do stuff, try things, try everything out, go everywhere you can, buy a bunch of crap, sell it, do something else. So yeah, there you go. That's the whole story. I look a little different, don't I, Sina? So yeah. Once it grows, it'll be different. It'll look a little different. Danrons? What's Danrons, Franco? Don't mind me as I eat this really crappy ramen from 7-Eleven on the floor. I got to live in this place like this for a week. And then I get to move to the place that I really like. Today and yesterday, honestly, this is why I'm doing this stream as well, because I just want to get this off my chest and get it over and tell everyone, like, yeah, I got the Bruce Willis. I got my Bill Murray haircut. It's back. I look like I did when I was 28. Maybe not facially, but scalpily I do. So today and yesterday have been incredibly hard for me, and I don't often have hard times I'm always happy. Everything's always fine. And I genuinely feel good 99% of the time, and I'm excited, and I'm always working on things, and I feel very creative all the time, and I'm very lucky and fortunate that my life has been easy, and the only struggles I've had are ones that I bring on for myself while doing work and making projects. I'm very, very fortunate. But today and yesterday have not been that at all for me. And I felt like I wanted to just come here and tell everyone this, get this thing over with, get it done. If anyone has questions for me later or even here now, I'll answer them and tell you whatever you want. But I moved to Town, USA. I'm not in Los Angeles. Thank you. Thank you, KOK. Okay, that's very nice of you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I got to change the subject because it's gonna get hard for me in a second. So I don't even know what else to talk about. I was going to say something else, but now I started changing. I said my brain won't leave the subject of, oh yeah, you asked where I moved. I haven't told anyone where I moved. I've just disappeared for a while until Los Angeles and the world come back to normal, because there's no acting work going on right now in LA. So I figured I'd go lay low somewhere, do something different, and nice wait until next year. Thank you again, Kayoken. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it's basically Peach Fuzz is Melly. Evil Greg, where have you been? You got to go watch the Dad channel. I've been there for 2 years, pouring my heart out into that channel, doing everything I can. And I honestly think it's some of the best stuff I've ever made. A second album just came out on the Dad channel. I just wrapped up season one of the series. There's new music videos coming out next week. So please check it out. But I'm going to be doing a lot more on this channel. I'm actually going to start doing this, like, some workout training videos, like vlogs of just me and how I work out. And it's pretty bonkers and weird how I do it, and how I work out. But I'm gonna document all of that starting next week once I get finally moved into the other place, because this isn't where I'm staying. This apartment, part of the sort of the problems I've been having and the major emotional struggles I've been having lately are because of, like, moving and, like, coming here and it not being what I thought it was gonna be, and just a lot of other stuff, personal stuff I've been dealing with. So it's very strange for me to feel these types of emotions. So anyway, once I moved into the other place, that will hopefully be, things will be better, and I will start doing the boxing and the exercise training, because I want to have a boxing match against someone, either another YouTuber or anything else. I'm not taking a hiatus, SR. I'm actually doing more now that I've moved. I'm going to be doing stuff on this channel, like I'm saying, this boxing and exercise vlog style stuff. Do it, Jimmy. Get over here, Ryu. Let's start boxing together. I'm still loading stuff to the Dad channel, so I'm not taking a hiatus. Check out the Dad channel if you guys didn't know. Yeah. Hi, everyone. Oh, there's almost 300 people watching this. So after this, Altoid, Yoda, and Ren are going to play, I think they're playing Red Dead. I just wanted to come on here and talk for a while and sort of get all this out. I'll tell you guys, my hair came back. And so now you guys can keep tabs on it and watch it and see how the progress is coming in March. And March is when it's supposed to start really blooming. Yeah, so Yoda's playing Ren Dead Redemption. Ren, is she going to be on camera? Yoda is going to stream Red Dead with Ren, the moderator you guys all know. Although she says she's not a moderator, but she basically is. And then we can all go watch that, because maybe I'll call Yoda and be on the stream or something. Because I have to finish setting up this stuff. So on the Dad channel, if you guys don't know about the Dad channel, I would say subscribe right now, because on New Year's Eve, here, I'm doing a 10-hour nonstop dance stream leading up to New Year's Eve, midnight East Coast time. I'm going to start dancing, and I'm not going to stop for 10 hours on the Dad channel. So if you like me and my dancing, subscribe now to the Dad channel. I'm about to hit 140,000 subscribers on that channel. I'm only like 400 away. So if everyone here watching wasn't subscribed and you subscribed, I'd probably hit 140 in a day or two. So if you're not, please do. I'm going to dance. You can party with me. Stop by the Dad stream. You'll have 10 hours to check it out. You can pop in and out. Or you can watch the whole thing as a countdown, because it's basically a countdown until midnight East Coast time of East Coast America. I'm going to dance till midnight, and then it'll end shortly after that. But I'm going to start dancing 10 hours before, and I'm going to keep going. Hopefully it works. I'm very emotionally drained and actually physically tired. And then the one reason I'm dreading doing this, I was gonna be fine doing it if things worked out with where I'm living right now. I was just gonna like sleep all day the next day, but I have to move the next day on New Year's Day out of here after dancing 10 hours nonstop. So my couch and everything is gonna be delivered in my pod, and I'm gonna have to carry everything up flights of stairs, move all of my stuff after dancing for 10 hours. So it's going to kill me. I'm going to be very tired. Every time I dance, even for like an hour straight, I shattered my heel as Keith, as you just saw on this GIF. Thank you, Gonzalo. Thank you. Well, no hair, no bones dance, please. Well, I can do the no bones, but I'll have to do some hair, some bones, because I have some hair now. Still got the bald spot. As you can see, it's still bald. Basically, there you go. It still looks like me. It looks like me from 10 years ago. And that's what I was very, very insisting upon. I told the guy, I was like, please don't make it look like... He was very realistic with me too at the same time. But when I first went to him, I was like, I don't want to look like I just got all this hair. I don't want hair. I like the hairline. I like the way Bruce Willis looked in that Quentin Tarantino movie. I like the way Bill Murray has looked. And that's what I wanted. So he's like, yeah, that's more realistic. And he said, a lot of guys come in here who are completely bald like you, and they just want a full head of hair. And that's never going to happen. I was like, well, I didn't think that would ever be possible, because there's not enough to put on the top. I'd be all bald on the sides. Saying Essa, I just did it because it was just curious. I just was curious. I was telling people on the top of the stream, I liked the way I looked. I've 100% liked the way I look. I'm very confident. I never had problems. I've always had girlfriends, because like, and if they don't want to date me because I'm bald, then I don't want to date them. And like, I've just never cared. I've genuinely never been self-conscious about it. But the reason I did it, because I was just so fascinated by it, and I was so curious. It's like nature says no, but there's a way around that, and that really intrigues me. So I did it. So here it is, and it worked. But apparently this will fall out, so we'll see if it does. My friends were saying, well, since you have such strong facial hair and your hair seems to be so thick on the sides, they go, you might be like one of the lucky ones where it won't ever fall out. It'll just keep growing. But it's supposed to fall out and then regrow. But maybe it'll be just get a little thinner and then regrow. Thank you, KOK. It's very nice of you to say. Thank you, guys. Thank you, thank you. So yeah, I'm sorry for anyone who's sad about this and misses bald Nathan and wants bald Nathan back. I'm still mostly bald, but I just couldn't believe my parents did not notice. I was like, what do you mean you don't notice? I'm like, what looks different? And my mom was like, you shaved your head. She's like, I don't like when you shave your head. I was like, Mom, there's hair in the front. She goes, I didn't even think about it. So there you go. Wow, my gosh, thank you. Dr. No Degree, still bobbing to more music every day, really with the vibe. Thank you. If you guys didn't know the dad character, some of you aren't subscribed to the dad channel. I would beg you to subscribe. If you want to see the 10-hour nonstop dance stream on New Year's Eve, please party with me and dad on New Year's Eve. Please, please, please. Then listen to you'll on the stream, you'll hear it. I made a mix. It's going to loop dad songs all the way till midnight, and then I got some special songs in there at the end once it turns midnight. So I made a mix. It's going to jump around between like the 28 songs, the dad songs, on the dad channel. The new album, if you're able to, please get it. It helps keep me alive. I worked very hard on the second album, and I'm very proud of it. I'm very happy. A lot of times when I make stuff, I'm like 90 to 95% happy with it. The album, I'm 100% happy with it. It's so freaking good. I'm so pumped. Thank you again, Dr. No Degree. And thank you, Shannon. Congrats on the new hair. It sounds so weird. And well done on the dad finale. It was amazing. Well done on the dad finale. Oh, thank you. Oh my gosh, Dr. Dinglebob, you guys, thank you. You're very, very, very nice. This is very, very nice of you. Yeah, I never thought I'd see it either. And then this guy told me it is possible. And I was like, okay, we must try. So thank you, Mr. Dinglebop. Thank you very much. From a distance, I mean, it's still thin. It's still bald. I think I got the logical transplant. The word transplant sounds so taboo, too. I don't even like saying that word, honestly, because it's not a transplant like most people get. Most people get right here. They cut a strip of hair from ear to ear. Like that. And they'll cut it, and it's like this thick. They'll take all the hair that falls in that line from ear to ear. It's like a smiley face. They take that and then they disperse it all over. So it's pretty invasive. And then they stitch that up and they close it, and your skin actually gets tight. This is what happens, where it pulls your neck and your scalp hair, scalp skin, tight. And then your skin stretches and it goes back. But they close up the gap of hair they pulled. And it's like super messed up and like crazy. But what I did was a newer, way modern, super innovative thing that, like, I just look normal when I go home. It's like, well, you know, there's like little scabs here and there, but like, it was, I looked basically like this. Congrats to your so then they take it and just put it here. It's so crazy how easy and effortless this was that it made me feel better about it, because I wasn't like, oh god, I look like a mutant and it's so artificial. Because it's funny, because I'm being a hypocrite right now and I'm contradicting what I normally say. I like au naturel. I like when I'm bald and I just grow it long and I look crazy. I always tell Yoda, just grow it out, because Yoda shaves his head, and I say, just grow it out, au naturel. And then here I am getting a hair transplant. But I don't like the word transplant because it's associated with shame and people being afraid of how they look, when I'm not that at all. But I don't mean to say all this to like defend myself, to like prove to you guys that I'm not insecure. Everyone gets insecure, I guess, but I just am not about my hair. I did it because it was fun to see if it could work. And Kaioken, speaking of dadass, this will fall in line with that. So I thought about this long ago. I was like, well, if I pursue dadass, basically, because what dadass is to me is like a spoof of Die Hard. Because Die Hard, he's like a relatable, he's a father, and he's like a relatable regular guy. And he has the Bruce Willis hairline. And I was like, well, if I look like I did when I was 28, which I looked like Bruce Willis, my hairline was like this, it works perfectly for dadass. So that was actually something I thought about. Thank you again, Kaioken. I thought, we need more if I do it, I can do more dadass. Hello, everyone. Welcome, everyone. Welcome. So, yeah, that's pretty much everything about it. We'll see what happens over the year, see how it works out, and see how it looks. I'm going to continue eating my horrible ramen. Thanks, SR. Thank you very much. Mr. Pick Dovid, thank you very much. That's very nice of you. Once I get to the new place and I'm all set up next week, I can start working on videos again. It's honestly killing me not being able to work and do stuff until next week. Thank you again. That's very nice. Thank you, Picto. Oh, someone said something about Milford. Oh, love your channel. Was just wondering, is Milford still being produced? Fresh Teeth, I saw your comment earlier. Sorry I didn't answer. Milford is done. I actually have it preloaded to this channel. I can upload it at any time. I think I'm going to do it. I'm trying to decide. I was going to load what I have loaded is the 15-minute version, but being one of my projects to do in this new year, since I've moved and I'm trying to give myself an easier life, is I want to finish editing the 30-minute version, and that's the one I wanted to put up. The one that I have done is the 15-minute version, which is much less of a story. So I want to work on the 30-minute and load that, and then load the 15 as a, like a bonus thing. But I feel if people see the first thing people see, I'd like it to be the 30-minute version, because that's the better version, in my opinion. GM, yes, I lost even more hair. I lost hair on my body. It fell down and came back around. I'm eating really crappy ramen, Joel, that I had to microwave because I don't have any cooking utensils here, and it turned it rubbery. Thank you, Timothy. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you. So that's a good thing too. Gross you. That's actually a good thing too, because me at 28 looked like more like Trevor because he had a little bit of hair in the front. Gramps, Act 4 is not happening for a little while. There's a lot of other... Hang on, I got a fart. There's a lot of other things that are going to be going on the channel beforehand. Some side story stuff and slightly different series. If you saw the finale and you liked Dad Ass, then you will be happy this year. Dad Ass is one of the things I want to work on. Also, if you guys aren't subscribed to me here on Nathan, please do, because this will sort of become like a BTS channel of me rambling and doing streams like this, and like and all my workout vlog videos I'm going to be putting up, and my boxing training. I'm going to do that here. And I'm also working on this like physical comedy montage that I'm going to load here. It's going to be, I wanted to do 500 falls in 5 minutes, but I think that might be too long and too annoying to watch and people will skip through it. So I might do 200 falls in 2 minutes, where it's just a montage of me hitting the ground 200 times in all, completely different ways and places, and in more elaborate, like weird falls and hang ups and trips, and basically just me hitting the ground 200 times as fast as possible in a super montage. So there, so there's a lot of stuff coming here. You do, Joey. Joey, did you hear my explanation? Everyone, praise Joey. I need to make you a moderator. Joey is the effects master on the Dad series. Joey Deutsch, everybody. I just rubbed my head. Look at that dot now. What is that? Why is that red just from me touching my head? Is this ramen a poison in it? Joey does the effects on like 90% of the effects. So Kane Pixels started doing some effects too. But Joey has done effects for me for a long time. The first thing I did with Joey was that Mad Max movie review where my head exploded. I was like, can anybody make my head explode? And Joey was like, I can do it. And he sent it to me and it was amazing and perfect. But he was like 14 years old. Couldn't believe you're still a child to me, Joey. What are you, like 19 now? Joey is an amazing FX master and very young. It's crazy. You're going to be making like blockbuster movies doing effects on huge projects in the matter of no time. I know it. Joey is amazing. I can't thank Joey enough for everything he's done on all the videos. I do have sensitive skin, though. That is something I should say. I don't remember the term. It's like dermographism. Like, if I scratch my back, just like I have an itch, it looks like cat scratches all over me. My skin does swell up. But this is weird that if I scratch my forehead, it's never really happened to my forehead. My gosh. Have you ever did voice Proton. For an MD game? Your voice sounds really cool. Oh, thank you, Proton. I haven't done any voice acting for an indie game, but I did a voice on a Fox cartoon for a season or two. Oh, you're 21 now, Joey? My gosh, you're like an adult. You're a full guy. You're a long boy now. Thank you, guys. Thank you all for donating. Oh my gosh, $87 has been donated. Thank you. Cringe gaming. It might be poison because it is from 7-Eleven. Anyway, I used to do an ASMR podcast. It was called Nay SMR. It was NAYSMR. And it was just a podcast of me talking like this. And I was like very quiet. I was just kind of whispering like that the whole time and just telling random stories and stuff. But if you like anything of me being ASMR-ish in any way, you should listen to my podcast. My Grave Stories podcast, where I read real grave stories, ghost stories, and spooky stories, and it's just me reading them and talking about them and reacting to them. And I'm starting that back up next week too, if I can get it next week or 2 weeks. But like, 'cause next week's gonna be really crazy with me moving a second time. I'm still in the process of moving into here, and then I'm moving right back out Monday. No, starting New Year's Day. I start New Year's to Monday. I move out. So, anyways. Yeah, that's everything that's going on in my life. What is that? Are you going to miss Velcro head when putting shirts on after? Well, so that's the thing. My head never did that. When I would clean up like my P peach fuzz on my head. It was never spiky. It was always soft. So I never had anything stick to my head because I didn't. I don't think it was enough to do that. But now it will be. But wanting dad to DJ my future wedding someday. Well, D-Punked, I remember you sent that to me. You'll have to talk to me. Send me a tweet or something. Because that would be fun. If Corona was gone, it'd be fun to do something like that. And we can figure it out maybe if things like go back to normal whenever you get married. Thank you, Jonah. I love the new look. Nathan Statham, yeah, I do kind of look more like him now. Chris is beyond. Ooh, Beyond Oasis. Perfect game. That's a good one. It's a rarity. He would be proud. I am proud. Thank you, Jonah. That's very nice of you. $87. Oh, wait. It's got to be more than that now. You guys are giving more. 216 people watching. 216 likes. Wow. That's nice. Thanks, guys.
I'm serious about wanting dad to DJ my future wedding someday.
So many farts. Oh, I shouldn't be farting while eating. Now I'm just eating my fart.
Love the new look, Nathan Statham. I spend all of Christmas playing Beyond Oasis.
Thanks, guys. It was a little weird. I was thinking, what am I gonna say to the internet? Oh yeah, I got hair. Don't worry about it. Or don't say anything, because apparently my parents didn't even notice. My mom thought it was cool. I did think my mom was gonna be upset with me. I thought my mom wasn't gonna like it because she likes me just being me, just being as is. But she's like, oh, that's cool. She's like, oh, when's it going to get longer? And I was like, this is not like my mom. She must have just been feeling like sentimental or like sad. She was pretty emotional about me moving out of L.A. I am going back to L.A. I need to tell everyone, I'm reminding everyone, this is not a permanent thing. But because it's such a quick thing, not a quick thing, it's just a year and it's just like a temporary thing, like a vacation or whatever. That's how I've been trying to think of it up until moving. That's how I was thinking of it. I was like, oh, I'll just go and then I'll come back. I thought it was going to be simple, but logistically it has been a nightmare and emotionally it has been a nightmare. And I wasn't expecting that. I really, really wasn't expecting that. It's been very, very hard and I have been freaking out and I don't normally do that. So having this, thinking about, God, I look different. People are going to hate me. They're not going to watch my videos. They're going to be like, you're a loser. You're self-conscious. When I'm not self-conscious, because that's not why I did it. If you watch the Being This Dream, you'll understand. If you haven't, please scroll back and listen. It's just a fascination thing. But anyway, so thinking about all this and feeling like I betrayed myself and I should just leave myself alone and be all natural and I'm not who I am anymore. And like, I actually started missing my bald head and I felt like a loser. You shouldn't feel like a loser. I should feel better. Everyone else who's bald and gets hair feels good. They're like, yeah, I feel awesome now. I felt like bad that I killed my old self or something. So on top of all of the moving stuff, I was thinking about that and I was like, I just need to do a stream where I tell everybody, yeah, the guy moved my hair 5 inches to a new place to sit and get it over with so people can think what they want. Ay, ay, ay. Matt Kelly, thank you. I personally watched a bunch of those dance videos. I personally have friends that are waiting on another. When are we getting another? Matt Kelly, if you haven't been watching the Dad Channel, you've missed a lot of dancing. Please watch the Dad Channel. And tell your friends to watch the Dad Channel because I dance and make music videos on that channel all the time. I make music. There's 2 albums. There's tons of dancing. I'm dancing for 10 hours nonstop as Dad on the Dad Channel on New Year's Eve. Please go subscribe. Please, please, please. I'm not stopping. Once I start dancing, I will not stop dancing until 10 hours later. And I want to stick to that because I'm a psychopath who likes to do really crazy stunts. And I say something, I proclaim it, I have to do it. But this week has been really crazy, and I'm thinking if something happens, and emotionally, do I freak out, or I get super tired because I've moved, and I'm moving again the next day. I have to move all of my stuff by myself, and my couch is enormous. I might have to take a break, and I don't want to take a break, but I might have to take a break. But if anything, I will be dancing and the stream will be 10 hours long and I'll be dancing most of the time. But I don't want to say that to make people think, because the whole point of this for me is to dance nonstop. That's the point. I'm one-upping myself. I danced for 1 hour nonstop in downtown LA as Dad when the channel first came out. And then I did 4 hours nonstop on Santa Monica Beach in public, never stopped dancing. And now I want to do the third one where I dance by myself with this the weirdest stream you've ever seen. A guy starts dancing, 10 hours later he stops dancing. I really like the concept of it, and this is the third and final one where I go big and I go 10 hours. And the next thing to do will be 24 hours, but that's just insanity. So if you like the dancing, please subscribe. Oh, thank you for subscribing. I appreciate it. Thank you, The Life of Ryan. I'm really close to hitting 140,000. I'm hoping during the 10-hour dance stream, I hope a lot of attention comes to it. And like, if you guys like and share that stream when I'm doing it, it will could very well become trending because it could be like a really popular New Year's Eve stream. I'm going to be doing it all day long. So if people like it and it gets tons of likes, it could get featured and I would really appreciate it. I want it to be as big of a spectacle as I can. So please watch it, even if it's just a little while, and give it a like. It'll really help me. It would be amazing. And then if new people show up, then I could very well hit 140,000 subscribers. Right now I'm at, let me see. Also this Nathan channel is getting incredibly close to 400,000. I have 394,652. So I'm like a little over, I'm at 348 subscribers from 395. So I'm 5,300 something away from 400,000 subscribers on this channel. That's not a lot of people. So that's great. So thanks for being here and sticking around for so long on this channel. This channel is not dead. There's many videos coming out in the future. Please keep watching. And on the Dad channel, I am 429 away from 140. Only 429 people. I think I'm doing that math right. 139,571. All right. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm getting up to an hour here on this stream. I just wanted to tell everyone that I got the Bruce Willis. I got the Bill Murray. I look like I did. It's my hairline. He followed my hairline to what it used to be and where my fuzz was still. So, still me. E, hello E, good to see you. Thank you for watching the Trevor videos. I loved doing those Trevor videos. I stopped doing the Trevor videos recently because I don't want to get shot by the police by doing something crazy in public, because I know that's what they like to do now. They like to kill people. So I don't want to be the guy that they shoot because they see a weirdo doing something that they think is crazy. Sheik No. Thank you, Sheik No. If you guys didn't know, there are direct donations in the description. YouTube won't take the 30% like they do from the Super Chat if you donate in the direct link in the description. You haven't watched my videos in 5 years. Mr. Thanos, hello, welcome. Well, if you didn't know, I've been for past 2 years, I've been putting my heart and soul and killing my body and bank account on the Dad channel. And it's been one of the most satisfying things I've ever done. It's very different, but it's still comedic. It's still funny, but it's also mysterious. It's got a lot of sci-fi in it, and it's got a lot of catchy songs. I think it's like the Keith Apergary songs taken to the next level. That's how I see it. So I would ask anyone who hasn't watched me in a while to please go subscribe to the Dad channel. It's called Dad Feels, F-E-E-L-S, and it's a whole big saga. It's a big story. There is also this one-off random videos, like random YouTube videos, because the whole story is Dad is a YouTuber, and I thought it would be a funny idea to have this like weird-looking dad doing something that young people do, trying to be the best YouTuber in the universe, and he's competing with people in their teens and 20s. But he looks like, you know, a lame dad. So if you watch it, I'll love you forever. There's really good music and there's tons of dancing. Basically, it's everything I've always done, but with a really good, not really good, but like a really big story, I should say. It's a big storyline. So anyway, that's that. If you haven't been watching, you haven't been catching up. me read some of these comments. Gramps, I really like the animated food. Oh, thank you. Versesca, I don't know if Versesca's here. Versesca is a subscriber and a mod in the dad world. She did the art for that. Shino! Hey, oh, it's Shino. Hey, what's up? How's it going? I haven't seen you in a while. How are you? I still Shino, but okay. Wait, what? Did you change your... What, did I call you something else? Did your name show up as something else? And I said something? Oh my gosh. Tree, thank you very much. Helix and Copper's Golden Day. Wait, what? Wait, what did you just say? Wait. I didn't get to read that. It's not in my notifications here in Streamlabs. Where is it? What'd you say about Copper's Golden Day? Who is that? Is that Brian? Who just commented and donated? Who was that? Copper's Golden Day, for you guys who don't know, was like indie short film I did with a friend of mine back in Massachusetts way before I moved to California. Hello, Randall. Welcome. Thanks for being here. Oh, no, because it said Sheikno. Oh, it's because your name is spaced differently and I wasn't looking at your avatar that I knew. I thought that's what you're talking about. I remember when I said that. Sorry about that. Shino, obviously I know who you are and I can see you in your picture. But it went by and I just didn't think because of the spacing in your name. Hello, Shino. I know it's you, but I'm sorry that I thought your name was someone else earlier. My group of friends all loved your stuff from back when we haven't seen anything for a while. Now I have a whole channel. Yes, you do. Thank you, The Life of Ryan. I appreciate it. I tried to like promote that, but it was – so here's the problem. I was trying to promote the dad channel in a really weird way 2 years ago, and there was two problems. People thought it was genuine. They didn't realize I was doing like an advertising method. I was doing all these weird cryptic videos on this channel where I was like being brainwashed and taken over and teleported. Your stuff from back when. We haven't seen anything for a while. Now I have a whole channel to watch on Dad. So I was basically trying to dump people over to the Dad channel so they'd be like, oh, what's happening? What is this? Nathan's been kidnapped. All this weird stuff's been going on. I was talking about how someone stole my face and my likeness and I was just going to sue them. It was all just to stir up interest in the Dad series and get people to then go watch the series on the Dad channel. It was just an elaborate way for me to advertise that I had a new channel and I was making a new storyline of stuff. So a lot of people didn't see that or didn't know what I was doing because they were confused by it and because it was too weird. And I didn't just say, go subscribe to the Dad channel like you would expect. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to do something different because I didn't think if I said, go subscribe to this Dad channel. People are like, because no one ever wants to do something. They don't want to subscribe to something else. It's like, it just doesn't work. You can't do that. So I was trying to do something to sort of trick people into going and like make them interested so they'd want to see what's happening. Like, wait, someone stole this guy's face? He's suing them over it? What? They stole his likeness? And then they'd click the channel and they'd watch it and they'd be like, oh, okay, I get it. This is like a story. And then maybe they'd be more intrigued and interested and I'd catch their interest. So I did that. And at the same time that I did that, YouTube was not sending notifications about anything I was doing. They weren't telling anyone anything I was uploading. They weren't telling anyone I posted in the community tab. I was getting so low attention on this channel that most people didn't find out about the new Dad channel. So I am willing to bet, Ryan, that that's why you don't know about the Dad channel, because no one really found out because no one was seeing anything I was doing on this channel at the time. Yes, Gramps. That's correct. What Gramps just said is the Dad channel is basically Nathan's song channel with some story. Yeah. It's a new musical project. I'm doing a character like Keith who had songs and Ray Amsley, he even had a song. And Trail Lewis had songs. All my characters often have songs. The Dad character, I wanted to do a lot of songs. So I made part of his character he's like a pop star. And I thought it'd be funny if he's a pop star who looks like a lame dad. So, yes, it's like a music channel with a big story. That's pretty much it. And then I do like random one-off videos here and there as well. Thanks, Raspberry.
Dad, wake up. Andor, eat the little towels.
Is that Andong? Did you say Andong? Nathan, I swear I see you everywhere I saw in Kirby Buckets when I binged it a little while back. How was that? Love Nutribullet. Thank you, Haru. Thank you for seeing Kirby Buckets. That was one of the most fun shows I've ever been on.
Nathan, I swear
I loved it. And thank you for watching Neutral. I'm the most proud of Neutral.
When I binged it a little
thank
while
you.
Back. How was that? Loved Neutral BTW.
If anyone here is new from the Dad channel, I'll ask you to subscribe to this channel. Everyone switch. Everyone go to the other channels. If you're new from Dad, welcome and thank you for being here. It really does help me if you subscribe. And if you're an old-time fan and you don't know about Dad, please go check it out. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone. And if you're new here, I would ask or recommend you watch Neutral, my short film. That's the thing I've made the most, that I've liked the most in my life. It's more of a personal project. Even though it's not really personal in my life or anything. Well, it does actually, there is one thing in the story I touch on that is personal for me. And something the character says. Sam Nail is just talking about Milford to someone else. I have the 15-minute version loaded to my YouTube and I can upload it at any time. But I'm thinking, I don't know if I want to because I'd like to put out the 30-minute version. It's all done. The 15 minutes been done and it's gone to film festivals. But I can't, you can unsubscribe. That's totally fine. Live your life for you. You probably shouldn't be subscribed to someone that you're not interested in. So adios and have an amazing life. And I hope you find a channel that you love. Thank you, DJ Roomba, for liking Neutral. I want to put the 30-minute version of Milford out first because that's the bigger, longer, better story. So that's something I'm going to be doing in this new year. Once I move out of this place, which I moved into yesterday, next week when I move to my final place for the rest of the year, I'm going to work on the 30-minute cut of Milford as well as doing all the other junk I've been talking about. Oh, the cameo and the community. That was such a tiny little thing, but I'm glad you saw it. And thank you, Robert, for donating. That's very nice of you. You guys, I've earned $118. That's too much money for me just sitting here.
Nathan, thank you so much, brother. You got my girlfriend and I through a very rough time, and Tom means the world to us. So thank you and continue being awesome.
Thank you. That was very nice of you. I'm glad you like the stuff.
You scoped town USA for new film locations. Neutral was great.
You're giving so much
in community too.
Jeez, you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Beta, if everything's back to normal and there is a too many games in 2021, I will 100% go. You know what Corona did to me? Thank you, Pervo. Good to see you. Oh, that's cool, Ren. If you want to watch Neutral, that'd be amazing. I also have a BTS thing you guys could watch after if you want. You know what would be cool? I wanted to put out a DVD of Neutral and Milford together and put them like out on like a disc or something, but I probably shouldn't say that because it's going to be a lot of work for me to do and it will take forever and it won't come out when people want it. I do all this stuff myself, so it's like really hard for me to get stuff done. I just want to like perform and just be the actor, but I have to like do all the production junk as well, editing and making of the DVDs, and it's a nightmare. But I think if you want to watch Neutral and a watch party in the Discord, that'd be amazing. If you guys don't know, I have a Discord. It's based on the character, the Dad character. And someone asked earlier, I think someone might have said, "Who's Dad?" Or whatever. Dad isn't my dad or anything. Dad is the name of a character I do. He's a robot dad. That's the best way I could sum it up in a very quick way. Oh my gosh. Sheikno. Hello. Good to see you. Welcome to my channel. Go sub or turn into a rock. It's the non-subscribe. Subcurse. Oh, wait. I can't read it when you space out like that. It messes my brain up. Non-sub. Curse. Oh, non-sub curse, like a gypsy spell or whatever. Thank you, Shino. That's very nice of you. So Milford is done for anyone's asking. I know people have been asked a million times. Milford went to a couple film festivals, and now I can put it out on the internet, finally, way too much long later.
It's the non-sub curse.
But one of the reasons it took so long
was because of Corona. It slowed everything down. It changed everything the way film festivals happened.
So it's done been to film festivals. I'm not going to bother submitting it anymore. I'm just going to put it on the internet, move on, do the next thing. So the 30-minute version, I'll put that up, and then I'll put the 15-minute up after. So this year, you'll see it all. Steven, thank you very much. Oh, I thought Steven donated. But hello, Steven. Yes. It's my own natural hair that came back. Nathan will have the fighting spirit. I do have the fighting spirit, and I will have it even more when I start boxing. What a great show. One of the best anime ever. Hajime no Ippo, the fighting spirit. I will train like Ippo. I will focus. And I will never give up. Good night, Shino. So, when the heck is Yoda and Ren playing Red Dead? When will they be ready? Can you guys hear my farts? I'm farting so much. Thanks again, Kyogen. One thing I'm debating. Also, I'm using my boxers as a napkin and a towel. Because I don't have anything here. I'm literally, all I have is this stuff I'm setting up for the dad finale. Glad that's done. Oh my gosh, what a bunch of work that was. That was a nightmare. I hope you guys watch the dad channel. I really hope you guys watch the dad season one. And all the music videos, if you haven't checked it out yet. I know most of you here have, so thank you to everyone. All I have is the stuff for the 10-hour dance stream. New Year's Eve, everyone. Come party with me, a.k.a. Dad, on the Dad Channel. I will be dancing here in front of a tinsely shiny background for 10 hours nonstop. I need to do some major exercising starting tonight and tomorrow to like make sure I'm in good condition. I'm going to go jogging and stuff tomorrow and get my stamina up and my endurance. But yeah, I'm using my underwear as at least this pair, a napkin and a towel, because I don't have anything here. I'm sitting on the floor. I got my computer and that's it. And I got some apples. I don't think VOD will kill theaters. Well, did you guys hear this? One reason I'll say that I don't, oh my God. Okay, I don't know who Dad is. You might want to go check it out. I know you know, that's for sure. Thank you, Kaoken. What they're saying is, I thought this was pretty cool, is all these like people are, all these stories are coming out about like how we're going to be entering another roaring 20s. And because we're like coming out of a depression, the crappy president that the universe hates is gone. Once things come back and the pandemic is over, we're poised to be entering a roaring 20s. And it's really crazy that it's actually the 20s again. Like, it's literally the exact same thing is happening 100 years later. So what they're saying is the roaring 20s, as in people are going to be wanting to go dancing, partying. They're going to dress up to go to CVS. They're going to be in the grocery store wearing their finest jewelry. People are desperately waiting to go feel good and be happy. That like restaurants, bars, movie theaters, bowling alleys, clubs, everything is going to be doing so well because people are just dying to go outside and live again. That actually like excites me and makes me like feel like, oh, that's kind of cool because I like the 20s. One of my favorite movies is Midnight in Paris, and he goes back with Owen Wilson. It's a Woody Allen movie where Owen Wilson goes back in time to the 20s in Paris, and it makes me want to go there so bad. So I think about like if we get to live that, it'd be amazing. If we get to do that all over again by ourselves, like the energy of the 20s. You guys want to see my Masato shirt? ADD. Oh, Masato. There she is. Can't see her. There she is. Let me read these. I'm talking over your donations. I'm just pumped for like things to be cool again. Like I'm sure everyone is. But like if it made me even more excited thinking, oh, is it going to be like the 20s? Because the 20s are cool. When you posted that GU picture on Twitter the other day, it gave me such a rush. What was the GU picture?
Oh, Game Underground. I know what you're talking about. Thanks, Sam. I forgot how many of my friends and I were there. Well, thank you. I'm glad you were there, and thank you for being here now. Thank you for donating. Oh my gosh, Kogan, what's a dad? He's a dad is someone who makes YouTube videos. That's what a dad is. Shoot the movie, but we went skating. Happy holiday. You guys are being incredibly generous. You're donating so much money. Save your dollars. Throw your dollar bills at dad on the New Year's Eve dance party stream. Don't forget, New Year's Eve, 10 hours nonstop dancing on the Dad Channel. Once I start dancing, I'm not stopping. 10 hours later, once the clock strikes midnight in New York City, Boston, Miami, all the East Coast cities, that's when I'll stop dancing. Actually, I'm going to dance a little bit after that into the new year. But I'm dancing for 10 hours nonstop on the Dad on the Dad Channel. Please go and subscribe and watch and party with me. It's going to be very fun. Hello, interesting tops. If you were a competitive eater, how many glizzies could you dance? I don't even know what a glizzy is. Probably not a lot. I don't have a lot of room. Thanks again, Kayokin. Oh my God, Raspberry. No Depeche Mode. No, never. I already have that planned. So, Raspberry, if I have to, I might wear an adult diaper in case I have to whiz. But I've gone 10 hours in my life without taking a dump or whizzing thousands of times. Most of the time I'm out in the day, I don't go to the bathroom. And then 10 hours goes by quick. So I think if I plan it right and I sip slowly on like Gatorade throughout the stream, I'll mostly sweat it out and I'll just keep an even balance and I won't have to go to the bathroom. Bobbert, thank you. I don't know, but I will do it, and I can do it. I danced, if you guys haven't seen it, on the Dad Channel, I've already danced for 1 hour nonstop in public, downtown LA. It's a camera was just on me. I danced in public on a sidewalk. People were walking all around me, filming me, taking videos. I danced nonstop for an hour. Then I one-upped it, and I went to Santa Monica, and I danced for 4 hours, and that's on the channel as well. Didn't stop dancing for four straight hours. You can watch the whole thing. You can scroll through the whole video, or you can watch it and listen to the music. So now I'm going to one-up it again and do the third and final one, and I'm going to dance for 10 hours nonstop. I don't want to go off screen bombs. That's the thing. I like doing things legit, and I don't cheat it in any way. Once I walk on camera and I start moving, I mean, for a bunch of it, I might just be doing like really simple things at all. Got this desk. I'm sitting on the floor with this computer. I'm supposed to be putting this thing together. I might just do some like, you know, simple stuff to rest a little bit like this at times because 10 hours is really long. So even if I'm just doing this, I'm basically taking a break, but I'm still moving. So I could even do like this. I think this is cheating a little bit, but I don't want to harm my body. I just want to dance for 10 hours and do some crazy spectacle for New Year's Eve. I thought it'd be a good way to end the year. I put more work into this Dad Channel than anything else I've ever done, honestly. So I really hope everyone subscribes. If you like me and you like what I make, I think you'll like the Dad Channel. It's funny, it's interesting, it's weird. It's kind of spooky at times and has really good music and is the weird man dancing like normal. So I thought it would be a good way to end the year with a real big bang, something crazy. So I've been talking about it for a long time, and I've been wanting to do it, and I think New Year's Eve would be a perfect time. And then I'm going to take a few days break, and I'll start putting stuff up on this channel and on the Dad Channel. There you go. Why cringe gaming? Does ramen often hurt stomachs? I eat ramen a lot. I like ramen. I've seen people do 24 hours too. I think it was in India. They're like one of the record holders was a lady dancing for 24 hours. I mean, my ankles would probably crumble after that. My foot does get sore after I dance for a while. So the 10 hours is I'm probably going to be limping for a couple days because my foot locks up. It doesn't lock up, but it gets like achy. And I can't quite go up on my tippy toes normally because it like loses strength in my left foot. After I shattered my heel as Keith in Texas at SGC, my foot has never been fully the same. I can still run and do like flips and all the stuff I used to do, but it does get tired faster, I think, because the muscles didn't come all the way back. Hello, Death Bulk. Talking Classics, BB. Thank you for liking Talking Classics. I don't, 25 hours fast. I don't want to. I think the record might even be over 24 hours now. The world record. I have to fart again. I was thinking about that. I'm going to have to do that. I'm going to keep stretching and while dancing, while moving. I mean, stretching even can be dancing because I will be moving and, you know, I'll stay on top of it. I'm not going to harm myself. I'm not going to go hard except for like at the end. I'll probably just go all out and then just collapse. But I'll do consistent dancing and then I'll take it easy and I think I can do it. I think it'll be fine. I think it'll be cool. It's another thing I'm just like really curious about doing, like the hair. It's like, I just want to do it. I want to do this weird, crazy thing just to see if I can, see if it works. So we'll see. New Year's Eve, everybody. Be there. Johnny, good to see you. I went to town, USA. I live where the dad character lives now. It's pretty nice here. But I'll be back in LA. I'm basically just hanging here for a year just to do something different. And then hopefully when Corona is basically gone, it'll be the end of this coming year, 2020, beginning of 2022. I'll be back in the sun living that Baywatch life, baby. Yeah, so that's the thing, bombs. I was going to do it in public as well. I have a 10, where is it? Somewhere around here, I have a 10-day portable battery. I bought this specifically for this New Year's Eve stream. I was going to use my phone to stream it, and then I have an old iPhone with all the songs on it, the playlist, and I usually tape it together. And I make this mobile rig. When I did another stream. That's actually how I did the 4-hour thing too. But I filmed that and didn't stream it. But I did a 3-hour dance stream once in Beverly Hills. And I had taped the phone behind it and had a portable speaker. And then the speaker just hung here and you guys could hear it through my phone because the speaker was right next to it. And I had that all like taped up to a tripod. And then I had oh, here it is. This is my 10-day battery. This thing will charge multiple devices and keep them charged for 10 days. I tested it and I played my phone that I use for music when I do the streams, my old iPhone. I turned my old iPhone on and hit play on YouTube videos and just let it play screen fully bright. I let it play for 10 hours with it plugged into this. The power didn't go down one light on this and my phone stayed at 100% the whole time. So I was like, well, it works. So I was planning on using this out in the public and I was going to wear a mask and I was going to dance in public when people walking around for 10 hours. And then I saw the weather and it's going to rain on New Year's Eve. So I don't like this aspect of the stream, doing it by myself indoors. I want it to be in public because that's a lot more fun for me. But I don't want to ruin the phones and if the water gets on the lens and it's like blurry and I can't tell and you guys are like, we can't even see you. It just could be crummy and crappy. And then someone could come and tell me to move and then I've been dancing for 7 hours and I have to stop at 7 hours. I'll lose my mind. So the best way to get a good, consistent, no problems, I can be Etherneted in, have the stream look good. Since I guess the big gimmick is that it's 10 hours. The public aspect, I guess, can take a back seat on this one because doing the 10-hour thing is like the big thing, I guess. So anyways, yeah. That's why it's going to be inside. But it'll be a fun New Year's Eve party. Yeah. Well, I guess I'll wrap this up because I have to get some things organized in here. I'm incredibly drained emotionally and mentally and physically. I kind of just want to go lay down and fall asleep. I drove for like 20 something hours yesterday, non-stop. I didn't stop. I drove straight. And then I got up and started doing all this other stuff. I went to the other apartment that I'm switching to. I unpacked my van. I repacked it. Oh, my God. I just can't believe. I just want to not do anything for a little while. Stream for a few more minutes. Yoda's still. That's what I was going to do. I was going to actually try to dump everyone. We all should all go to Yoda's channel, and I'll just lay in bed in the chat. Or if they want to, like, if they want me on the stream, I can just call Yoda and just chat or whatever with everybody, with Ren and Yoda. But I think Ren and Yoda are going to play Red Dead Redemption on Yoda's channel. So if you guys don't know Yoda, Altoid Yoda in the chat, he does the merch for me. He designs a lot of the dad shirts. Like, I'll say, hey, do this. I do this. I want to do a Town USA shirt. Can we make it like this, this, this? Because I don't have the time to do all that stuff anymore. I used to do all the Keith shirts and stuff. I just can't. So Yoda does it for me. He's my merch master. He also comes up with ideas on his own that are amazing. And he's my thumbnail master as well. He made the thumbnail for the New Year's Eve stream. So if you want to support another small channel, Yoda is getting close to 1,000 subscribers. You can go subscribe to him and watch him play Red Dead Redemption with Ren, another amazing supportive person who helps me endlessly with my life. So Ren and Yoda are going to be playing Red Dead, and I'll come hang out. Someone said something, and I wanted to answer them. Let me scroll here. Maybe it was something Joey said. Also, I just wanted to pull attention to Joey. Joey Deutsch in the chat. Amazing FX artist. Amazing. Did like 99% of the effects on the Dad channel. Dad channel is not done. I don't like when I say things and it might sound like I'm saying he did them, as in it's over. It's not over. Joey, I'm going to need you to do many, many more things in the future. So thank you for being here, Joey. August Jazz, I really want to. I really just want to relax, but I can't until I... It was annoying because I was going to be living here in this apartment, and then things changed, and I can't be here. I can't stay here. So I want to be happy this year, so I have to go to this other place, and just want to be I want to be comfortable and happy and relaxed. So I'm moving a second time, not very far away, and I do still skateboard fearsome. I love skateboarding, and I'll skateboard forever. I have my skateboard with me. I love skateboarding. There's a skate park not too far from here, which is cool. So what I was saying about, oh, resting. I was going to rest New Year's Day after I did this dance stream here, and I was just going to hang out and relax. Fortunately, I have to move one more time. So once I move, what I like about this, I'm going to be so willing to relax. It's going to be outrageous because I'm going to be so dead from this dancing. I'm already mentally drained and emotionally drained from moving and being or moving to where I am and tired. And then dancing, and then doing the dad series and the second album, and then moving a second time, I'm really going to be happy to lay down and just relax. So I think I will appreciate it more, is what I'm trying to say. And it will be much more worth it after. One thing I really liked, I equate it with, like, I like taking a shower when I'm really dirty. Like, it's really fun to, like, go get super muddy and just go out in the woods and do a bunch of junk and you're filthy. Then you feel like you earned that shower. You did a bunch of work and you're covered in grease. Then you really want that shower and you get in your pajamas and you want to get super comfortable. So I'm thinking of the year like that. It's like I go really hard at the end. I get super exhausted, super sweaty, super tired. I move. My stuff is a mess. It's then when it's all organized and set up, I can take the shower, relax, and hang out. So I'm very much looking forward to that day next week. I guess it'll be like Tuesday or so whenever I finish. I have farts. I have so many farts. Oh, is this a good mic? Is it sounding really good right now? I wasn't sure if it was, you guys could hear because this place I'm living right now, the heater is on like a vent over there, and I can hear the fan, so I didn't know if you guys could hear that. Damn, congrats, thank you for $10.
Also excited for the 10 hours dance stream.
Thank you. I am too. Thank you very much. Do you guys notice how, like, I always do a Yoda impression now. Thank you for the $10. Oh my gosh. Because I've been making fun of Yoda for so long, I now just do it genuinely. I genuinely talk like him, and I don't like it. Thank you very much for that. That was very nice of you. Thank you for $10. This mic is just, I've had this mic forever, and I never use it. I like using the headset. It's so much easier. Just plug it in, use it. I have to have like a tripod here with this arm and then the wire. It's like, oh, there's so much stuff just to hear the sound of my mouth. I wanted to get a new gaming headset to make it easier, but maybe it won't sound so good. But if people are liking it, that's cool. My heart is making farts. Yes. Oh, I think it's my heart is doing farts is the line. But Cereal, thank you for knowing and for quoting that. That's my favorite song on the new Dad album. Everyone, if you haven't listened to the new Dad album, my character Dad, the album is called More Music because it's the second one. The first one is called Music. More Music, the last song, is my favorite one on the album. I love all of them. I genuinely love all of them. Almost tied all the way through, but that one I like it a little bit more. Thank you, Raya. Thank you. I don't see what the words say on the bottom, but thank you for buying Dad merch. That's an, oh my gosh, Super Fred. What are you guys doing? This is going crazy. This is a very casual whatever stream on the Nathan channel, which I didn't think anyone would be paying attention to. But thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah, this is basically my Charlie Brown sweater. I got this from Kohl's like 4 years ago. 3 years ago? No, maybe it was 4 years ago. I do listen to Mac DeMarco. Yes, I like Mac DeMarco. Thank you, Raya. That was very nice of you. I hope you enjoy your merch. I appreciate you. If you buy merch, everyone, you're supporting me and Altoid Yoda because he gets a cut of the merch since he does a lot of the designing. You know, he gets a pretty good deal. You guys should remind him. A lot of people who design for people just get paid to do the design. And then it's like, that's it. That's your money. I felt like being generous. And I said, Yoda, I'll give you a percent of all sales forever. So he actually gets more money. I don't think he realizes that. So next time he gives me lip, remind him that I'm his boss and he's got a pretty good rate. He gets paid for things he didn't even design. Hope you appreciate it, Yoda. Now everyone go watch his stream after this one. I'm going to be watching. I love Red Dead. I wish I could play with them. I don't have my PlayStation. I don't have anything here. Someone said something to me. Nathan Barnett. Congrats on the air. Oh, thank you, Snapple Wapple. It's ATT, but Barnett, but thank you. Thank you for saying congratulations. Yes, everyone. The reason I started this stream was to say, hey, everyone, I look like I did 9 years ago, 10 years ago, maybe longer. Who knows? I look like I did when I was 28. Relocated my hair 6 inches. And I don't know why. I just did it out of boredom. I'm very happy with myself. It has nothing to do with not liking the way I looked. I said it, most of you probably heard that if you've been here since the beginning. For people who are just joining, I'll recap. The reason I did this stream before I end it, I'll say again, for anyone who's curious, anyone who is bald and might want to do it, do what you want, live your life. I genuinely didn't have any reason to do it. I had a friend who did it, another friend who did it, and I was truly just fascinated by it. And I was like, I'm going to see if I can get the Bruce Willis. And it worked. I mean, obviously, I like it. I did it because I like the way it looks. I like Bruce Willis's hair in Die Hard. It's pretty thick in that one. What's the Quentin Tarantino movie that's like really violent? It's Bruce Willis is in it, and he's dating like that Russian girl. And what is that one? Fearsome, I'll tell you in 1 second. I do remember that, Gramps. I remember when that dad danced with me on the first 1 hour dance video downtown LA in front of the Bradbury building, the Blade Runner building. Pulp Fiction. I really like Bruce Willis's hair in Pulp Fiction. He's just got the hairline. It's thin in the top. It looks cool. I do like a hairline on people. If people have like a receded hairline, I genuinely think it looks good. I think it suits a lot of people's heads. And one thing I associate with balding and with hairlines is you seem a little bit like beaten down and withered, and I like that. I like looking like worn and tired, worn out, because I feel like it just looks cool to me. And I like clothes like that when you, like, you wear a pair of pants or a jacket till it's destroyed. You don't want to be like super destroyed, but like, you know, some like stylish wear and tear to you. I always thought hair was like that. When people who had hairlines or like bald spots, I always thought it looked kind of cool. So that's why I, partly why it must be why I never really cared about balding, and I just always felt fine. Just didn't matter to me. But I do like the hairline that Bruce Willis has in that movie. So I asked the guy if he could do it, and he said, yeah, he could do it. And here it is. I got it. And here we now we'll see what it looks like when it gets a little longer. And that's why I did it, because why not? I like to do things, experiment, see what happens. And I don't think I look too much different. It actually kind of feels like a dream, really. I feel like not a dream come true, and I'm not trying to say it like that. Like, it's a dream. It feels fake. I feel like this didn't really happen, and I'm in an alternate universe. But it's also probably because so many things have changed in my life within a day. Well, not a day, like within like 2 weeks. That I almost don't feel like I really know what's really going on right now. Like, what's real. And I need it to like sink in. It's going to take a while. I'm in a totally different place. I'm alone, and I have hair. Oh, what happened? Why and how and where and when? That's how I feel. Things are really weird for me right now. And also, I just went through doing so much work on the Dad series to get that finale done and to put that second album out. And now I don't have to do that. My life is so, I just feel like, but I'm used to like editing every day and running out and getting a shot and recording vocals and sending lyrics to this person and equalizing this, and I was doing so much and moving at the same time, and now everything's like stopped, and I'm like processing everything, and it's been hitting me hard, and like I've really been, I had a very hard time the past like 48 hours, and I don't, and it's very unexpected. That hard time was very unexpected, and if I keep talking about it, it's going to give me another hard time, so I have to stop. But anyways, life is crazy is basically what I want to say. Someone's going to watch this afterwards and be like, what's, this guy is nuts. So anyways, yes, Aqua. It's still mine. It's my hair. It's just sitting in a different spot now. It's been conveniently relocated. And I don't have a funky scar. I don't look like a weirdo medical patient from the 1800s. But I have lots of farts and they keep falling out. Still got my classic bald spot. Can't get rid of that. I started losing my hair at 21. Yeah. And then I moved to LA when I was 24 and I had the hairline. And then I started around 26 is when the bald spot started showing up. And then 28, I basically looked like this. So, and then it, you know, well, went away after that. Snapple, I know. I agree with you, Snapple. Hey, Fisher, it's funny how many people come to this channel who know about the Kirby Buckets Disney show I was on. I feel like this channel, a huge portion of the subscribers are Kirby Buckets fans. So many people talk about Kirby Buckets on these streams. That's funny. Hello there. Hello, Fisher. Good to see you. Hey, Shingo. Welcome. Thanks for being here. Do you guys think... I know I have a beard, so that's throwing me off a little bit. It's throwing my face off. It's changing my face a bit, too. But
I don't look too different, right?
I mean, I used to look like this. It's still me. It's still a hairstyle that I did have. Hello, Butt the Poncho. Welcome. So one thing I will say is if anyone ever wants to do anything because it makes you feel good, and not that I needed this to feel good. I don't want to sound like that. I feel like I have to keep like covering everything I say and like explaining. I always explain too much and I ramble too much, but I did feel good. I was very happy. I don't think people should hide who they really are. Just if you can be comfortable with yourself, do it. But if you're not the version of yourself that you want to be, do it. Do whatever the heck you want, man. you're only here for so long. Roll around in the freaking mud every once in a while. So I do think people, there are probably a lot of people out there who want to do things in their life that they're afraid to do because there's a change and they're afraid someone might say something. Who cares? I don't care. I want you to change if you want to change. That being said, I was very happy as myself and never needed to do it. My dad's bald. My uncles were bald. My brother Seth's bald. It's normal. And I liked the way I looked. I actually got sad when I got the hair because my bald head that I knew so well was gone. And I actually started getting really upset and I cried a little bit when Frankie, my dog, was my son, I guess. It's Siobhan's dog, one of my ex-girlfriend and best friend, Siobhan, her dog, who became my dog when we were dating. I always went like this. I would bend down on the floor. I'd be like, Frankie, and I'd just like put my head like this. He'd always come over to me and just lick my head. He'd just lick it, and lick my head. And I just let him do it. And he liked it. So I started thinking like, oh no, Frankie can't lick my head. But he still can because I still got the bald spot and I still got the hairline. So he still got spots to lick. It made me so sad thinking about that because I was like, I'm gone. What did I do to myself? I was fine that way I was. But my friend was like, you're dumb. Most people are excited after. And they're like, I got hair. I can mess with it. I can do stuff. And I was like, oh, I'm a loser. I betrayed Mother Nature. But I guess Mother Nature made us. And it was a human who did this. And brains, evolved brains, are the ones that figured out how to do it. So I guess Mother Nature did do my hair. So anyways. That's my long ramble rant. Yeah, pervert. It's weird. Like, I always thought I was fine with change. I mean, I think for the most part, I still am. I can be pretty adaptable. I don't really... I am a nostalgic person big time. I know that. That's like some things are hard. It's hard for me to let go of some of the better times in my life. Not that times are bad now, but like times I had that were really good. I always often think about them, and I don't live in the moment as much as I should. I've learned while talking to my therapist. It's been helpful. But, yeah. I guess I'm just saying, do what you want to do. I did this for the random reasons of seeing if it would work. And it did. And now it's done. And now I need to go do something else that will stimulate my mind. Yeah, that's true, pervert. This year has been hard for people a lot. I've been very fortunate this year with this. 2020 was actually a pretty great year for me. I made so much stuff that made me really happy and satisfied. I was busy every second of 2020, like literally every second. I'm very fortunate for this year. And I know that sounds weird because 99% of the world don't feel that way. And it was really crappy. But because I couldn't go anywhere else and I couldn't go on as many auditions and I was just doing auditions from home, I couldn't do any other acting stuff. I couldn't do any pitches. I couldn't do any other writing. I just worked on my own stuff every second and I got so much done. And I did so many live streams as the dad character that I got so many donations. I was able to save money. And now I can like relax a little bit and just make stuff comfortably on this channel and on the dad channel this year and not have to stress too much. And also I'm trying to buy a house the next in 2022. I'd love to buy a house. Someone who said Scab Crowley, I didn't move too far away. I'm still in the United States. It's like a 2-day drive, but almost 2-day drive. Yeah, 2-day drive. But I can fly back to LA if I need to. Who is the most famous person you befriended in LA? Probably Arnold Schwarzenegger. He and I hang out a lot after that one video we did together. I don't know, Franco. I don't really know. I don't know. There's a lot of people who are successful that I've run into and done some things with. I mean, Raya, I could very well dye my beard white. That might be kind of cool. Ooh, should I do a white beard sometime? I wanted to shave my beard on my birthday and keep the mustache and have a mustache like Arthur from Red Dead, also like my dad. My dad has a really big mustache and he's had it since he was 17. Bombs. I don't know. That's a thing I've heard though. I don't know if it's a thing with like people who are like comedic or funny or like performers who are always like on. Maybe it's just because you're like that, you're doing it to, I don't know, counter something else. I don't know. Oh, I don't know if I guess Vsauce is famous within YouTube, but I was gonna maybe say like someone like, I mean, like Martin, my friend Martin Starr is pretty well known. And then Danny Brown. Yell. But Vsauce, I guess, is really popular. Michael. What does he have? Like 16 million subscribers? It's funny because I never think of people on YouTube as famous, which is really dumb because they're some of the most famous people in the world. But my mind always goes to like TV and movies, like who I know. Like Milana. I came close with Milana. Milan and I knew of each other for years, and then we did a little TV thing together, and that's when we first talked. That's the girl who plays Diane in the Dad series, if you didn't know. Milan is incredibly popular. She's the AT&T girl. I met Danny because he knew of the Dad channel. He tweeted Dad and said, Dad is the best YouTuber. And I was like, Danny Brown knows the Dad channel? Oh, yeah, then there's Alpha. John Morrison is incredibly famous. He's a WWE wrestler. I've known John for a long time. If you watch some videos of me and John on this channel, look up Glory Quest. There are some really old Glory Quests on this channel from like 2005 or 2004. The ones later, I did a Glory Quest with John Morrison in maybe like 2009 or 10 or 11, around then. John's awesome. So I was really happy to get John in the Dad finale as Alpha. Alpha is so funny. It's like my favorite character in the ending. The end of season one. Danny Brown is one of the best rappers in the entire world. He's awesome. I'm very fortunate that I got to meet him and work with him and become pals. So, yeah. Everyone I've ever met is like a very talented person, and I'm very happy to have been worked with all of them. Like Joey here in the chat, Joey Deutsch, FX Master. Oh, you saw Fisher, you saw Spare Change? I have a quick little part in that movie. Oh, is it on Hulu? Where'd you watch it? I actually never watched that. It's on Amazon. I gotta watch that. I've never seen it. I have a small part in a movie called Spare Change where I was a homeless guy. And I remember being exceptionally filthy in that. I want to grow my hair back out like that. I love it when it's wild. Thank you, Joey. It's true. You are an FX master. Thank Joey here, everyone. If you like that, the spaceship you saw in the Dad finale, CFB. You guys remember when you see CFB, the planet, the big red planet in the sky on the Dad series? Joey put it there. Joey has done amazing effects for me. And he always integrates them into the scenes organically. I'm very, very, I mean, blown away by your skill. You should be charging people millions of dollars for your skills. Thank you. Is Yoda ready yet? I gotta go. I'm falling asleep here. Oh, he did start streaming. Can we start dumping people over there and I'll go in his chat? Let's see. Where is it? Someone probably already posted it. There, he's live now. All right, everyone, let's go here. Click that link. I'm going to end this stream now. We can go hang out in Yoda's stream. He's playing with Ren another mod who helps me a lot. She's amazing. It was Ren's day the other day. Every Wednesday, don't forget, it's Ren's day. Tell Ren you love her. She's a very, very, very kind lady who never wants anything in return, and it makes me feel bad. So I try to show my appreciation to her. Thanks for being here, everyone. I thought I'd tell you that I got freaking hair. They took my hair from the back and stuck it here. It looks pretty natural. Really weird. I was having anxiety about telling my mom about it, and I was stressing about it because my mom doesn't like my, I had a tattoo before and on my arm, and my mom always hated it. And she's like, she definitely let me know about it all the time, and it made me feel guilty. And I was like, Mom, I just want to live my life. Let me do what I want. But she hated it. She just doesn't like tattoos. So I eventually got it deleted. I always say deleted. I mean to not say that. I tried to correct myself before I said it. Removed. I always say deleted and erased. I got my tattoo removed, not because my mom wanted me to, but because it was really a pain in the neck for me to cover it up for the characters. And like Keith wouldn't have a tattoo. All these – the dad character wouldn't have a tattoo. Most of the characters I had wouldn't have a tattoo. And I was like, I'm so tired of covering this up. So I got it removed. It still shows a little bit. I got to get it finished up, but this has been years now. I just don't bother. Anyway, because of how my mom is with that, I was like, oh, God, if I tell my mom that I got a new hairstyle, she's going to kill me. So I told her the other day, and she did the complete opposite. She was like, oh. At first, she didn't notice. I said this 100 times. Sorry if you guys are hearing the same story a billion times over. But she didn't notice at first. I was like, Mom, you don't notice? She's like, oh, you cut your hair short. Why did you cut it so short? And I was like, Mom, this hair on my head. And she's like, oh. She did. I'm like, how do you not know I'm bald? I've been bald for like 15 years or whatever. So anyway, yeah. She didn't freak out. When she then noticed, she was like, oh, that's cool. When's it going to like get longer? And how long is it? She was asking me this question. So I was like, wow. It was like a major sigh of relief. And like, I just thought she was going to hate it. And this is another sigh of relief for me to tell all you guys, because I'm like, I can't just show up on the internet someday and be like, hey, guys, nothing's different. And be like, everyone's like, wait a second. So yes, I also want to restate that I'm a very happy person. I like the way I look. And this is not, I don't have low self-esteem, and I wasn't doing this to like hide myself or anything like that. I mean, everyone should do what they want. Do it for your own reasons. Get hair because you hate your bald head. Get hair because it makes you feel better. Do whatever. But I got mine out of pure fascination after watching my friends. And obviously, I like it. I'm not going to lie. I think the hairline looks cool. So when it gets longer, it'll be fun to be like, oh, I have something to comb. So there you go. That's my long ramble. I thought it might be interesting, particularly for people who are balding and might want to hear this. Because I remember there was a kid here on CTI. I keep talking. I'm supposed to end this and go to Yoda's stream. But there was a guy on YouTube. I think the guy, like, people were saying he like kind of like lost his mind. What was his name? He had like a weird name. It wasn't FaZe. Like, it wasn't like one of those FaZe people. It was something. But he got like the tattoo on his head, and then he got it removed. And he was like documenting the whole process of getting it removed. And then I think he went and got another tattoo after he already regretted getting the hair tattoo, I mean. You know, people can get a tattoo on their head. It looks like you have hair, but it doesn't. And it's like weird. His looked really bad. But he documented the whole thing. And it was actually pretty interesting to see it get removed and see it go back to normal. And I thought doing this could in a way be interesting for some people to be like, oh, wow, that's what a hair transplant is. And I will say again, I don't like the word hair transplant because it sounds like it's a bad association with that word in my mind. It's like a shameful word. But I did not get the traditional type that most people get where you have the big scar on your head. I got this very new method that's just clean, and they're done in half a day. I was out of the office at 2 p.m. and I just went home and everything was fine. So that's pretty much it. All right. I'm going to wrap it up. So I'll go to Yoda's now. So if you want, you go to Yoda. He helps me with my merch. He's the merch master. He does all my merch for the dad stuff. He makes my thumbnails for me when I don't have time, and he makes really good ones. So thank him for all of his hard work. He works hard, and he also streams for like 20 5 hours all the time. And even if there's only one or two people watching, he just is a stream maniac. So go show him some appreciation. Subscribe. Maybe he'll hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. He's getting really close. There's his link to his stream. So anyways, if anyone is interested in getting a new hairstyle, it's possible in 2020. It's pretty remarkable what they can do. So do what you want. LA, they got really talented people. So anyways, that's it. Here it is. The same me you always knew. Just the one from when he was 28 years old now. Thank you, Connor, for thinking the merch is fire. I appreciate it. Fearsome Vloggers, I will check out your channel. I know that YouTube blocked your comment, but I will go check it out right after this. Thanks for being here. Fearsome Vloggers, you said, how did I do the hair thing? They just took it from the back and moved it 6 inches forward. Thank you, Piper. It is a little red. I will say this part of my skin isn't normal skin color fully yet. It's still a little red. Once that goes away, it will look less like a hard line. And it's really short. It's shaved short, so it looks like a hard line. To me, it looks not 100% right because of that, because of the redness and how short it is. But once it grows a little longer, what will help it, in my opinion, is how it will look a little bit thinner than the sides. And I'll be like, I will actually be able to relax at that point because I don't like it like it is right now. I don't like it this length at all. And it's like so short on the sides that like it almost looks like it's not even there because it's just so buzzed short. And my hair, it gets lighter when it's short. My hair is dirty blonde naturally. So anyways. Hello, Nastard. Welcome. If you haven't seen... Oh, thank you for liking the beard. I appreciate it. If you haven't seen me in a while, I will ask you to please subscribe to the channel I've been working my heart out on for the past 2 years. It's the Dad channel. It's called Dad Feels. I'm really close to 140,000 subscribers, and I'm very proud of the videos I've been putting up. There's a very big story. It's a very big series with a story, and there's really catchy songs. So if anyone here is an old time fan and haven't seen me in a while, I'm putting stuff on this channel starting early in the new year, starting next week. A lot is coming. You are so talented.
Thank you for all that you do.
Cassandra, thank you. Wow. That was huge. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh my gosh. $50 freaking. Thank you, Chuck. Thank you for watching. And thank you, Piper, for posting the link to the Dad channel. I will say thanks, Butt the Poncho. Adios. Thank you for everyone who does know the Dad channel. And if you don't, give it a chance. Check it out. I think you might at least like. Thank you, Zach. Thank you for subscribing. It's crazy how much I have to tell everyone because I was posting videos on this channel advertising for it, but YouTube just never told anybody. Nick Dubois, good to see you again too. Wow, that was a major one. Thank you so much. I love you. And everyone always asks when the Dad music is coming out on vinyl. I can't. Thanks again, Cassandra. The vinyl is too hard for me to do. I'm so sorry. Thanks, Nastard. Thanks for being here. Everyone, I'm going to say it one more time. If you're an old Nathan fan and don't know about the Dad channel, a good thing to see is New Year's Eve. A good way to start the Dad experience would be the New Year's Eve stream I'm doing on the Dad channel. It's a 10-hour nonstop dance video, dance stream leading up to midnight on the East Coast time. I'm going to dance for 10 hours nonstop until the clock strikes midnight, New York City time, and then I'll party into the new year with you. Watch the stream on the Dad channel. I'm going to try to get as many people as I can there, as many thumbs up, as many likes, as many new subscribers as we can. Hopefully it becomes like the biggest trending thing on YouTube. If enough people like it, YouTube will hopefully share it with your friends. Tell everyone as a lunatic dancing for 10 hours nonstop into the new year, and hopefully people will show up, and hopefully you guys dance along with me. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. And there is a bunch of stuff coming to this channel too, so you got a lot to keep your eyes on. Thanks for being everyone. I'm going to try to stay very busy this year while also relaxing. And now I'm going to actually end the stream. Thanks for listening to me. This did help me feel a lot better because I've been really, really feeling, I've been feeling very bad the past 2 days, and it's been pretty crappy. And I've been wanting to tell everyone about my new hairstyle on top of all of that. So I got that out of the way. So thanks, everybody. It's pretty weird, I know, but here we go. This is one of the experiments of life. We'll see. I can't quite look at it when I look turn my head. We'll see what comes of my life with my new hat. All right, thanks for some vloggers. Thanks for being here. I'll see you guys later. Do it, Meister. Send it to your grandmother. Send the 10-hour dance stream to everyone you know. Thanks for hanging out. Goodbye, Oaklight. See you, Cringe, Mari, Adam, Jonah, August, Piper, Sam, Evan, Kush, Miguel, Lady, everybody. Go, Gobloken. Pervert, Zach, Chip, Smoog, Franco, everybody, adios, Chuck Fox, Cooper, Miss So, my friend, Jimmy, Ryu, adios, dude. Oh, Jimmy, I can't find the shoes. I don't know what happened to them. I might have packed them. I don't know what the heck happened to those freaking British Knights high tops. I gotta send those to you. But I might have lost them in the move. I feel really bad. I'll have to talk to you about it. I was going to give my friend Jimmy here. I have a pair of British Knights that are like brand new. British Knights high tops from like the 90s or something, the 80s or whatever. I don't know what the heck happened to them. It was a hectic last couple days moving. But I'll talk to you about it. Seeing your name just reminded me. So I wanted to tell you as soon as possible. But once my pod of stuff gets here, I'll hopefully find them in there. Electrosaurus, you think you missed the whole thing, yes, but scroll to the beginning and listen, or just go to this new stream and we'll hang out there. Yoda is streaming, Altoid Yoda, everybody, Merchmaster, click on that link if you want to hang out in a stream. All right, well, Jimmy, I'll talk to you about it later. All right, goodbye, everyone. See ya, Ellie, Souls, Lapis, Ease 900s, adios. I'm clicking goodbye. Yeah, BKs, British Knights, super cool shoes. All right, everyone. See you later. Bye-bye.